Hello again, and welcome to part two of my graduation series. This time, we will leave the Hollow for Hogwarts. Potterhead running clubs, Slug Club, Armchair to 5K, to be exact. Now, I chose this run to be part of my graduation series because old Sluggy's birthday was April 28th, the very day that I graduated to marathoner. Besides that, my running journey began in an armchair to 5K fashion, so I thought it was appropriate. Shortly after my running graduation, I had another graduation, purely academic, of course. That's right, my master's graduation. Being the intellectual that he is, I'm sure that Professor Slughorn wouldn't mind if we took a quick peek into that day.
Of course.
Outstanding Graduate Student Award, Webster University 2019, Meredith Rice, Northwest Arkansas Campus.
Hello everyone, my name is Meredith Rice, and I wanted to start off with a quote from a famous Harvard Law School graduate. We did it! That Elwood certainly has a way with words, doesn't she? Yes, we did it. We wrote papers, we balanced life outside of the classroom with what we did in it. We conquered Capstone, well, as much as anyone can conquer Capstone, and we became masters of our craft. Recently, I completed my first full marathon, 26.2 miles. While others, and I'll be honest, oftentimes myself, thought that it was crazy to take on these two commitments at the same time, I found that they correlated and directly impacted each other. For example, you have to have courage to sign up for a race distance that you've never tackled before. Courage to try new, seemingly impossible things. Courage to sacrifice the way your life is now for something better. And you have to have the courage to say, hey, I can do that. The decision to start earning a master's degree is the same. So, to my fellow graduates, congratulations on being courageous. Now, as you might imagine, running any sort of distance requires discipline. For someone who's not naturally athletically inclined, like myself, it required a very large amount. I couldn't just expect to show up on race day and be able to finish. I had to put in the training hours by myself, out there on the roads or on my treadmill. As master's students, it was the same. It took immense discipline to stay on top of all the homework assignments, study for tests, and complete projects. So, to my fellow graduates, congratulations on showing discipline. Finally, my latest running experience made me prove my perseverance. There were a lot of times that I wanted to quit, that I wanted to just go home and eat the biggest, juiciest cheeseburger that I could find. But I kept putting one foot in front of the other and finished. There were also times during this program that I felt that I couldn't do it, that I lacked the skills and the knowledge to see it through. Actually, remember that thing called the capstone that I mentioned? I felt it there, oftentimes, strangely enough. But again, I took it one round, one assignment, and one week at a time, and here we are. So, to my fellow graduates, congratulations on persevering. Now, I've congratulated my classmates on being courageous, showing discipline, and continuing to persevere. But there would not even be a race without the support of certain people. Therefore, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our teachers and Webster University for their lessons. I also want to say thanks to our biggest fans, our family and friends here today for their support. Again, we would not be here today without either one of you. So, to my fellow graduates, congratulations again. Congratulations on making it to this finish line at last for your well-earned prize. We did it. However, we have one final question we have left to answer. With our courage, our discipline, and our perseverance. What will we do next? Thank you.
Meredith Lynn Rice, Master of Business Administration.
Well, that was fun, but we better get back to the run.
My thoughts exactly.
The charity partners? Yes, plural. This is a club run after all. For this run were the Harry Potter Alliance, Transfiguring Adoption, and the Protego Foundation. HPA turns Harry Potter fans into heroes through their work for equality, human rights, and literacy. Transfiguring Adoption is a magical organization that supports foster and adoptive families through a Harry Potter-based curriculum. And last but not least, the Protego Foundation fights to end the abuse of the creatures in the Nomad world, inspired by the Wizarding world. Now that is quite the club. And here is the club bib. As you can see, you have all the charity logos and the PHRC logo. And in the back are some potion vials because Professor Slughorn was the potions professor at Hogwarts. I chose 1220 for my number as December 20th was the infamous Slug Club Christmas party. I wonder if I would have made the club or if I would have been a server with Neville. Who from the series would have made your club? Comment below. Disclaimer before we get started though, this is merely a fan appreciation video about the virtual race I mentioned. I'm not affiliated with nor compensated by Potterhead Running Club or Random Tuesday Inc., who owns the rights to its content and creative property, nor the charity partners associated with this event. Okay, I can take a hint. Let's go. I was going to wear a graduation robe or my robe from before, but I figured that would be a bit dangerous, even for academic purposes. I was saving this for a special occasion. My own liquid luck.
One sip and you will find that all of your endeavors succeed. At least until the effects wear off.
Better move this back. Still plenty to learn.
You must insist you accompany me back to the castle immediately.
Oh, all right. I think it's medal time anyway. I've got two words for you.
Merlin's beard.
Merlin's beard. Oh, it's cute. It's very cute. If you're wondering why I'm wearing my robe, it is because the first time that we see good old Sluggy. He is impersonating an armchair in his striped pajamas. I don't own any striped pajamas, but Horace likes to be comfortable, so I think he would appreciate that I'm wearing my comfy robe to introduce his medal. Okay, for the ribbon, we have a striped ribbon, again, like his striped pajamas. And it says Potterhead Running Club 2019, PHRC. The medal itself is a very convincing armchair, but it's really Professor Slughorn.
What gave me away?
I could tell by the feet. His buttons are gaping a little bit there.
It's all in the upholstery. I come by the stuffing naturally.
In that same pinstripe pattern, and you have his little graduation cap, which he always seemed to wear. I found that very cute. It says in gold lettering, because he likes the finer things in life, Slug Club Armchair to 5K, Potterhead Running Club 2019. I was excited about this medal, but it is even cuter in person. That is so cute. On the back, there's not a quote, but you have Horace's hourglass, which stalls if it has stimulating conversation. It is really pretty. It has serpents and the green sand and everything. Love it. Very dainty chair for bulging buttons, I must say. All right. I think I need to go jump in my armchair now. As you heard in my graduation speech, running has taught me so many lessons. Yet, like Professor Slughorn, I'm always on the lookout to collect more. Unlike Professor Slughorn, however, I'll stick to collecting lessons instead of people. Or venom.
Not leaving, are you?
Yes. Sorry, Sluggy. Lots to learn. Before I go, though, please like, comment, subscribe to be a member of my club, ring the hourglass, bell, 2 times for notifications, and until next time, keep learning.
Be brave.